Welcome everybody to another video of Ancient Greece Reloaded. Today we will talk about the famous goddess Hebe, pronounced Evie in Greek. By the way, if you like the video, please hit the like button and subscribe to our channel so as to stay tuned for upcoming videos. Alright. In the tradition of ancient Greece, the female offspring in the home served any guests. Even the daughters of deities were not exempt from their duties. As the youngest daughter of Zeus and Hera, it was Hebe's job to bring her golden chalice filled with nectar and ambrosia, the food and drink of the gods and the sustenance of immortality. Also included in her duties were the tasks of riding her mother's chariot and drawing the bath for her brother Ares. Despite her seemingly mundane duties, Hebe had advantages too. She had the gift of eternal youth, and that was reflected in her adolescent figure and fresh-faced appearance. In later days, after Heracles was granted his divinity, she became his wife and they had twin sons together. Hebe had influence over eternal youth and the ability to restore youth to mortals, a power that appears exclusive to her, as in Ovid's Metamorphoses, some gods lament their favor mortals aging. According to Philostratus the Elder, Hebe was youngest of the gods and responsible for keeping them eternally young, and thus was the most revered by them. Her role of ensuring the eternal youth of the other gods is appropriate with her role of serving as a cupbearer, as the word Amphrosia was linked to immortality, undying, and life force. In art, she is typically seen with her father in the guise of an eagle, often offering a cup to him. This depiction is seen in classical engraved gems as well as later art. Eagles were connected with immortality, and there was a folklore belief that the eagle, like the phoenix, had the ability to renew itself to a youthful state, making the association with Hebe logical. Hebe is known as the child of Zeus and Hera, but there is another myth that states Hera conceived her by eating wild lettuce while dining with god Apollo. Either way, Hebe was often to be found serving up the nectar to the guest gods and goddesses of Zeus. This is, of course, until the day she tripped, had an embarrassing wardrobe malfunction, and her breasts fell out of her dress. Apollo fired her from her job as a cupbearer, and she was replaced by young Ganymede, a boy and the lover and prodigy of her father. Although Hebe would return to her previous role during the Trojan War, when Ganymede was too upset to continue. According to the Odyssey, after the mortal life of Heracles ended, he ascended to Mount Olympus, where he was awarded both divinity and the goddess of youth as his wife. These rewards were for his heroism during the Gigantomachy, the war of the gods and the giants. But they had to get past Hera first, as she never cared much for Heracles, the son fathered by her husband and one of his many mistresses. In the end, Hera came around and Hebe and Heracles were married. They went on to have twin boys, Alexiares and Antiketus. One of Hebe's better known roles was her part in a tragedy written by Euripides in 430 BC and called Heraclide, meaning Heracles' children. The protagonist Iolaus is an old man and friend of the deceased and now divine Heracles. Iolaus calls upon Hebe to make him young again for a day so that he can fight the enemy Eurystheus who tried to kill the Heraclide. For the records, Iolaus won. And at this point we have reached the end of our video. Let us know in the comment section below if you have forgotten something to talk about in the video so that other viewers can read and learn from your comments. If you liked the video, remember to hit the like button and to subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching and stay tuned for upcoming videos.